What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Tier 1 Concealed YouTube channel. Today, we're going to be discussing the differences between the Axis Slim and the Axis Elite. So the first and main difference that you guys probably notice is the shape of the Elite, and we wanted to make it follow the contours of the pelvic region a lot better than our previous holsters, mainly for comfort, but it also helps in concealment in some ways that we'll get into later. It's not really to say that the Slim is a bad holster, it's just you can always be constantly improving, and that's what we're trying to do here at Tier 1. So you'll probably notice when you're comparing these two, you'll notice that the Elite just has a lot more compact profile. It doesn't have the retention out here on the mag side. It also doesn't have a bunch of retention out past the trigger guard. And that was just we wanted to make it a lot more compact overall to aid in concealment, less printing, more comfort, and so on. So that being said, there's still some people that prefer the profile of the Axis Slim, but at the end of the day, it's up to you to kind of cater the holster to your level of comfort. Okay, so throughout the testing of, even through the Axis Slim, we've started to find kind of hot spots in the kydex that would start to wear at an accelerated rate and that we didn't really like. So we started adding these kind of strategic gusset points that just added a lot more strength and rigidity. I like my belt to be pretty tight and it helps with concealment, but some holsters that I've used will kind of give into the belt and start to flex a lot, and that will kind of take away from the concealment. So adding these gussets really helped with strength and longevity, but also with aiding in concealment. So when we were working on slimming down the overall profile, we experimented with retention a lot. And in the Elite series, you'll notice that there's no retention on the outside like there is on the Slim. And that's because we were able to move it inside towards the gun and make it so it's just one screw like the Axis Slim. But on the gun side, we also made it so you only have one retention adjustment screw. So it helps with, there's a lot less moving parts, one point of retention. So when we rework this, there's just a lot less real estate that you have to conceal and deal with, and there's a lot less kind of fine tuning. The retention on the Axis Slim is still good, but it does take a little bit of fine tuning and experimentation because all four of these screws can affect the retention. Whereas on the Elite, it's just this one. You can crank these ones down and just experiment with that one, as well as on the mag side. One of the very obvious design features of the Axis Slim that carried over to the Elite is the multi-axis flex center. We carried over that design and kept using the shock cord because through a lot of testing, we noticed that this kind of flex, the rearward and forward, not just this kind, also helps in comfort and concealability because everyone's bodies are different. And when you're moving around just through your daily use, the holster needs to move with you. So rather than just having one hard hinge point, having that little bit of flex really helps a lot in comfort. And a lot of people will counter and say that that doesn't help, that is bad for, you know, holster placement and consistency and stuff, but I've got quite a few reps and the consistency is very good. After we designed the Elite, we started working on our own proprietary clip system, and that is the Easy Adjust system. It just makes it a lot easier if you're, you know, out at the range experimenting or at home just dry firing, working with ride heights and stuff like that. You don't have to completely remove the screws to change the ride height or even the height of the claw. You just have to loosen them, and it has kind of a detent system that will click up and down into the different notches. And on my personal holster, I prefer the DCC clips. I've just been running them and I really like them. So it doesn't have that feature, but it's the Easy Adjust system is still on the claw. So if I want to move that up and down, all I have to do is loosen the screws on the clip and I can click that down, up and down into different positions. So another cool feature of the Easy Adjust system is our pressure stacks on the concealment claw. It has a few different, well, it comes with four, but you can adjust the amount of pressure you want to, you want your belt to push in on the holster. So right now, since I'm kind of a leaner guy, I like to have all four on there just to give maximum pressure in there. But on bigger dudes, wider dudes, whatever you want to call them, you can take those off because they might not need as much pressure to conceal the gun. So if you want to go look a little bit deeper into the Easy Adjust system, we'll link it below. Go check that out. So the Slim still has a lot more available options as far as guns and light combinations go, but we are constantly adding, literally every day, molds to the Elite series. So if you don't see your holster in the Elites, it's almost guaranteed to be in the Slims. But just remember, we are constantly working every day to add pretty much every option we can to the Elite series because it's an amazing holster and we want you to be able to carry your favorite gun in it. All right, guys, that pretty much covers it for the comparison between the Slim and the Elite series. If you guys have any more questions, drop them below in the comments or hit us up, customer service, Facebook, Instagram. We're always answering the questions. But let us know what you guys want to see next. If you have any more questions on our holster line, any gear, any drills, anything really. We love video ideas. But don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.